But asset quality concerns remain for the Kerala-based NBFC after the flood. So are bad loans on a rise? Let's find out from Managing Director George Alexander Muthoot. Mr. Muthoot, thanks very much for joining in and taking out the time to address your numbers with us as well as the growth trajectory for you. Let's start off with the September quarter and the historic high for gold loans that we've seen, as well as the overall picture for the quarter. How has it been for you?
See, the quarter has been good. We have seen good growth in the just the gold loan portfolio as well as in the overall loan portfolio. We have reached 35,000 plus as far as the consolidated portfolio is concerned. And as far as the standalone gold loan portfolio is concerned, we have crossed the 32,000 crore mark also. That has been really historic, and that's a good performance in this quarter.
Right, so let's talk a little bit more about the one-offs that we've seen, and because of delayed payments from customers, you've seen an increase in interest income coming in specifically for a few quarters, which spiked your yields to about 24%. Are you expecting normalization of the yields back to 2021 levels going forward?
Yeah, I think we have normalized it to 20-21%. That's what we see going forward also. The spike in yield in the last quarter, last year, this quarter, it has eased off. And now going forward, we should be seeing the yield at 21%, around the 21% range. I think it has even tapered off to that constant level.
So just to get an idea from you, for a lender like yourself, there are two ways which you make money. If the underlying asset price increases, which for gold hasn't been happening because it has remained fairly range bound in the recent past. And the other point is increasing your customer footprint meaningfully. What is the direction that you intend to take in order to make sure that the second happens, if at all the prices for gold don't give you that additional leg up?
So first of all, I need to correct you with the sense that the increase in price of gold doesn't actually give us more profits. It only means we can lend more to a single party. Other than that, it doesn't give us any extra yield, or rather our collateral which we have becomes little more stronger if the gold price goes up. Other than that, on the yield, there is nothing we get because the gold price goes up. Having said that, the second part of your question about customer footfalls. Actually, customer footfalls have started increasing. Our total customer base is also increasing. We have taken quite a lot of steps towards marketing and sales, and I think that is showing good results. As of date, we have about 2 lakh customers coming to our branches every day for transacting with us, either for getting a new loan, for closing their loan, or for interest payment. So that's a footfall we have. And I think that customer base is certainly good for us, and it is gradually increasing only.
What is the plan for the subsidiary, sir, going forward?
See, the main subsidiaries we have is the home loan subsidiary, which has a portfolio of about 1,800 crores as of date, and also the microfinance, which has about 1,200 crores of portfolio. So the third subsidiary is a Sri Lankan subsidiary, which is very small. It's about 1,100 crores of Sri Lankan rupee. You take half of that, maybe 500 crores of Indian rupees, the loan book in that subsidiary. So these subsidiaries certainly should grow. And today our subsidiaries constitute about 10% plus of our total portfolio. We wish to bring it to 15% by the end of the year. Probably we'll reach around that 15% target by end of March. That's the subsidiary's growth. As far as the gold loan business is concerned, we would like to grow it by about 15% plus in this year, just the gold loan portfolio.
All right. So let's talk about the expectation regarding the asset quality figure going forward. What do you expect to see in the consecutive quarters?
See, the asset quality has been absolutely impeccable. The quality of the assets we have, the gold which we have with us, on which we have lent 32,000 crores, is perfectly good. All the gold is good quality. Whatever is there, which is stolen gold, etc., we have already written off as loan losses. So what we have, the quality of the asset is good. It is only that we give more flexible time to the customer to repay his loan. Because of that, sometimes this crosses the DPD date, and that is seen as a technical NP. So whatever NPS you see are not a loan loss at all. We have never lost even 1 rupee because of an NPA account. An NPA account is just a technical NPA. The gold is good, the customer is there. When the customer releases the gold, we get the full money. If by chance, even after giving him some time, the customer does not come and take his gold, we auction it. Even when you auction it, we realize 100% of the principal. Probably if the interest is 23 or 24, we may end up with 17, 18 or 19%. So we have never lost anything. Again, finally, even the technical NPS in this quarter has come down. From 4% plus, it has come down to 1% plus in this quarter. It's 1.9%. It's, of course, it's irrelevant for a gold finance company. But having said that, NPS is something which people look at it. So ours is 1.6. And that is also because we had a 6-month scheme last year, which has now run down. So we have only the 12-month scheme now. And that is the usual scheme. That is why the NPS are now normalized to 1.9%.
Right. So have you witnessed any pressures with regards to liquidity due to the current crisis that we've seen in the market? Because for a company like yourself with strong ROEs as well as huge capital tier one capital accretion, it should not be a bother for any lender to you.
See, we have been talking to when all these problems came up or the confusions came up in the financial market. We have been talking to the to all the banks, to all the mutual funds, etc. And the general feeling we get is that they are all comfortable with the business model. All the banks who have lent us money have also got a small gold loan portfolio. They know the strength of this gold loan portfolio. It is just that they are not able to do this as well as Muthoot. The mutual funds also understand us very well. They are very confident. Today also, we have a sizable presence in the CP market from the mutual funds, and they are very comfortable. But in the last 2 months, banks have been little tight-fisted in lending to or renewing and lending to NBFCs in general. And probably we have also been categorized there because many of the banks say their overall exposure to NBFCs is high. So although they know that they could give us more money, they are unable to do that because of their overall exposure limits. But now that Reserve Bank has eased things a bit, things are looking up better, and they are also coming up with more funding to us. But we are also in the process of going forward with the retail NCDs because we have a very good retail NCD franchisee. And we have a good customer base for that because we have been there for decades. People still trust Muthoot, and so we'll be going for retail NCDs also next month.
All right. What would the quantum of that be, the NCDs?
Yeah, probably the last one we raised last year was about 3,000 crores. So probably we'll do that, and we'll do a 3,000, something on that level we should be looking at. But the quantum is not finalized as yet. It will be done more frequently now.
All right. Just one last question, sir, before we let you go, in terms of growth targets for FY19.
Yeah, I told you for FY19, the gold loan business, we would like to grow it by 15% plus. And also the subsidiaries, certainly, which is today about constituting 10% of our total book, we would like it to reach 15%. Hopefully, it may reach 13 or 14% of the total book, diversifying the total business from gold loan to the housing finance. And we have also started the vehicle finance business as a 100% subsidiary. It will be reflected in the next quarter.
Got that. Mr. Muthoot, thanks very much for joining in. Appreciate you taking out the time and highlighting and clarifying all of those details for us. That's the management of Muthoot Finance. So optimistic on growth, double-digit growth overall, and subsidiary business also likely to expand by the end of the year.
Well, just before we wrap up the show, Devina, though, just want to mark two names yet again. HCL Tech is now down about 6%. So just a quick market update there. That stock at 954 is at the lowest point of the day. GAIL is 4.5% lower, I presume, on that CLSA note, which speaks about the petchem business having a bit losses in quarter three. So that stock has corrected quite a bit as well. Otherwise, it's largely okay. Z on the other side has gained about 3%, and pharma seems to be doing well. But I'm sure the FNO show will take forward all of these conversations. So it's a wrap on this leg of Indian Open from Devina and me and the team that put this show together. Thanks so much for watching.